What's up, everyone? I'm Luke Cogliano, and you're watching episode 22 of the Allen Live Show. I have two reviews for you this week, and let's get right to them. So first up, I saw Drive. This is Ryan Gosling's latest film, and it was just a beautiful, beautiful movie. The filming in this was just incredible. Every shot of every scene was just so well done that you were just completely enthralled the entire time. And this was just something that, like, really, I had never, like, just imagined that something could be this, like, spectacular. This was just so wonderful to watch. And just because of that, this movie was just totally worth seeing. I thought Ryan Gosling, he's just proving time and time again that he's just getting better and better with every movie that he's been making, and this is no different. He's very good in this. The only thing is and this goes for the entire film, the whole cast is very low on dialogue, and, it's kind of an issue sometimes, just because sometimes the story doesn't quite make sense, and if you're, like, missing stuff, it's kind of hard to piece together what's going on, just because there isn't a lot that they're saying. But he definitely has this, when I was watching this, I almost felt like it was, like, Taxi Driver. Because this movie was, like, I thought this was basically the new Taxi Driver. It was just as gory, it was just as gory, and that was really surprising to me, and it was I remember when I saw Taxi Driver for the first time, it was just Robert De Niro being so, like, just alone, and so kind of, just being this character who's just, like, very, sure of what he's doing, and he's just very confident and doesn't really need to say much, but it definitely felt like Taxi Driver. So there isn't too much dialogue, and it does hurt the movie a little bit, but not enough to make it not worth seeing, because this is absolutely worth checking out. So besides Gosling, I thought Albert Brooks, who plays the, like, head gangster, was really the only other good character worth watching in this. Because most of the other ones either don't have enough dialogue or are just, like, not very believable or well done. Like, I didn't think Carey Mulligan was that good. Ron Perlman didn't do very well. And I just wasn't impressed by the rest of the cast as much as I was Ryan Gosling and Albert Brooks. But Albert Brooks was very, very good. He was just this really dark character that haven't seen a lot of Albert Brooks, but whenever I've seen him, I know he's supposed to be, like, this really funny guy, and he was just perfect in this. He was so good at just taking over this role of this very believable town gangster, and I was completely sold on him. So both of their performances, Ryan Gosling and Albert Brooks's, were amazing, and the filming in this is so beautiful, and it's just such a engaging type of movie, and I was just completely impressed the entire time. The soundtrack for this movie is also very fitting, just for the entire mood of the film. It's kind of this, it's usually a very slow-paced type of soundtrack, and it really works when you're watching it, because it's just a really, a lot of really nice songs that go along with what's being shown, and it's just, it's always good to see when soundtracks match up perfectly with the movies that they're in, and this is one of those times, and that also just added to how good this movie was. So another note on the violence, it doesn't really get too violent until, like, closer to the end, but it's not too, it's, like, well pulled off. Like, these are very, like, realistic and really gruesome murders that are going on, but it's not, like, forced at all, and it's really just, it was kind of a shock, I guess, but it doesn't hurt the movie. So I absolutely love this. Definitely check it out in theaters. Besides the fact that it's kind of hard to get emotionally invested in some of the characters, that's not a big problem. It's a beautiful film to watch, and it's totally worth checking out. So go see it, and let me know what you think. So next up, I saw Warrior, and this movie was awesome. It was this vastly emotionally investing story, and it was just amazing. I loved this movie so much. It was actually made last year, and they didn't want to release it the same time as The Fighter was coming out. And I have to say that this was way better than The Fighter, in my opinion. I wasn't a huge fan of The Fighter. And this was just way better, in my opinion. I just thought it was so good, and all the characters were very good in this movie, except kind of Tom Hardy, because he just wasn't really, wasn't really given enough to work with, I guess, and some of his, the things that he was doing in the movie were kind of cliche and just a little phony, I guess, but Nick Nolte was amazing. He was the best one in this movie. He played the father, and he was just stunning. Every time he was in a scene, he was just very believable. He played this kind of recovering drunk, and he was just like spot on. And it was just absolutely incredible to see him. I really want to see more of him, and I also want to see more of Joel Edgerton, who was the older brother. And he was really good in this, too. I haven't seen any of his stuff before this, and he really made me want to go see more of his work, because I have a feeling that he's just a star that I've never seen before. This movie gets to be pretty long. It's almost 2.5 hours, but with the engaging dialogue and the film and the unique film style, it's just so... it's so easy to just stay within the idea of this film and just keep your interest. And the situations that they're having each character go through are just really breathtaking to see on screen. And I definitely recommend that you go see this, because I think it's way better than The Fighter, and it's just something that was unlike anything I've seen in a long time. It really kind of got to me. It was just kind of, it got me really sad. It was just a really entertaining film, and I totally recommend seeing it. So go to that if you get a chance, and let me know what you think. So that's it for today's episode. As always, you can subscribe up top. You can leave a comment down below for today's question of the day, which will be at the end of this video. You can leave a video response, and you can like this video and give it a thumbs up. So today's question of the day is, what is your favorite fighting movie? I'll see you guys next time, and that's it.